to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. Appreciate you tuning in and hope you'll stay with us because you're going to hear a lot of good music. Dottie has phone operators that will listen to you and pray with you, and we will share those requests at the end of the service. So I want to say thanks to last night to Pastor Alan Ratliff for being here and giving me some time off. Yesterday was a big day in my life. I got another great grandbaby, and I think we've got a picture ready to show if Travis works his magic there and gets it pulled off. We'll have to show you one of the pictures. So there she is.
Just day old.
She was born at 8:15, I think, yesterday morning, and she weighed 7 pounds, 13 ounces. And so she's got a full head of hair, they said, enough for a hair bowl, see there. And so she's good size and a good, healthy baby, no problems. And so I really thank the Lord for that. And then last night I had a great-granddaughter to graduate from the eighth grade, so see, the older you get, the more you accumulate, and the more you've got to tend to. And so, but I mean, I just counted the Lord's blessings on having a new baby in the family and then a healthy teenager to graduate from the eighth grade. So, you know, we are to count our blessings, and sometimes we take things for granted, but it's wonderful to know that the Lord understands us and He is working on our behalf. It doesn't always happen exactly like we want it and exactly like we think it should go, but He's taking charge and He's going to bless us. Well, here's the scripture for tonight. For those of you that couldn't read today, that was too sick or just not able to see, this is in Matthew, the 5th chapter, talking about Jesus. I love to read the words of Jesus. It says, "And seeing the multitudes, He went up into the mountains, and when He was set, His disciples came unto Him. And He opened His mouth and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men shall revile you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted they the prophets which were before you." That's the first 12 verses of Matthew, the 5th chapter. Jesus telling us how, if we want to be blessed, this is the way it is. And so we sometimes need to adjust some attitudes and some things in our life in order to get where that He can bless us. But I'm glad that it's possible that that we can receive His blessings and that we do. All right, just before we pray, here's Brian has called for his dad, Charles, that had a stroke this morning and needs help. All right, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this scripture. We thank you that you have told us how we are blessed, how we can be blessed, and we do thank you, Lord, for your blessings on us. And we thank you, Lord, for this service tonight and for the church that has come to help and to enjoy and to join with us and to bring church into the homes of in hospital rooms and nursing homes, wherever folk are that have joined us, Lord. We want this to be a service that will be uplifting, one that will be an encouragement to them. Bless their guests and their phone operators, and Lord, just let tonight be one that we have heard of people being blessed and saved and healed and delivered in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, we're glad to have a good number of folk with us tonight. It's been a little while since they've been here. I think they've all been busy or whatever. But anyway, they're here tonight, and we have the new Vision Pentecostal Church from Richmond, the Richmond Road, 3313 Irvin Road, Richmond, Kentucky, and with the pastor Vicki Young, and they do have a phone number, 859-200-2201, and this is the new Vision Pentecostal Church, so let's welcome them right now.
Praise the Lord. We're so glad to be back tonight. I want to lift up the greatest name that ever was, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We're just glad of the Lord. Praise God. Amen. All right, Brother Mike.
When I came into this world, just don't recall. Thank you.
that new birth. Amen. Praise God. I'm glad one day, thank God, the Lord reached down, thank God, and saved me. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm glad tonight of Jesus. Amen. If you've not experienced that new birth, what are you waiting for? Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. I remember the night it happened. I know where it happened. I know what was going on. Glory to God. But I know there was a change that night. Amen. Glory to God. I praise the Lord tonight for being here. We just love Sister Margaret and everybody up here tonight. And just love all of you. We watch your station so much. And praise God. Just feel like home family. Amen. And we really are by the blood of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. But we love the Lord. I ain't going to take a whole lot of time. Praise God. But right now, if I could, I'd like to make a few dedications. Praise the Lord. We've got so many people that said they would be watching. I work for Dr. Charles Shaw in Richmond. And praise God. We've got a whole lot of patients, thank God, that come by and tell us that they're going to be watching tonight. I'd like to right now say hi to Carol and John Hall and all their family, Mildred Wicker and all their family, and Georgie Clark. Praise God. Laverne Tipton, praise God, and her family, praise the Lord. A good friend of mine, Ramona Mahaffey, and her mama, Sister Barbara Rose, praise God. We want to dedicate that to you, praise God. We got some more later on, but we're going to let Brother Estel come on and sing his song, praise God, at this time.
Praise
See
the Lord.
Maybe lame, I cannot walk, baby blind, and cannot see. I'll fly away on winter bumps when he comes after me. When my time comes to go.
Praise God. He excites me. Amen. Glory to God. I've never been the same since He saved me. Praise God.
Amen.
I got memories of being a sinner, but I love my memories of being a saved person. Amen. Thank God. I'm glad I'm saved tonight. Praise the Lord. Sister Connie's going to do us a song right now. Praise the Lord. Amen.
We're up here for one reason. One reason is that's for Jesus Christ that died upon that cross for each and every one of us.
Amen.
Troubles come and I can't find an answer.
All you have to do is ask, friend. Amen. If you're in need of a Savior, praise the Lord. He'll save you. Amen. He'll make a change in your life.
Amen.
Glory to God. John 3:16 says that God gave His only Son. Thank God that you wouldn't have to perish, but you could be saved. Amen. Have eternal life. Praise the Lord. Amen. We love Him tonight. Appreciate God. Praise the Lord. I think it's found today.
About to sing a song saying, I've been blessed. I just want to say that I truly have been blessed. I lost my mother like 5 years ago, but I've been in my husband's family for almost 38 years, and I have a very precious mother-in-law, and I just want to dedicate this song to her, Miss Evelyn King, and also we want to just send out a message to our residents out at Dominion in Richmond.
Yes.
We're dedicating all of our songs to them, and also we want to let them know that we'll see them guys next week.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
When He walks among us and all that He does, all of His mercy and all of His love, it's the wind of the rider.
God, I want to make, before Terry sings, make a few more dedications. Wayne Wells and his wife, supposed to be watching tonight. Connie Lane Hart, her husband and family. Praise God, all of our church, New Vision Church, that's watching tonight. We send it out to you. Praise God, my Uncle James Johns, my Aunt Linda Rose. We got some friends, Wanda and Darnetta Dixon. Praise God, we especially want to send it out to them. They're having some sickness right now. Donald and Mitzi Kelly and a good friend of ours, and Thelma here, her sister, Etta Ray. Praise God, we want to send it out to all of them and all of you, friend, that's watching tonight. We want to send the program out to you also. Friend, especially if you don't know the Lord as your Savior, praise God. We want to sing these songs for you tonight. May God bless you. And call in tonight. Give your heart to the Lord. Amen. And I promise that you'll never be disappointed in Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Terry, it's your turn, honey. Where you at?
See?
Yeah. Okay.
I'd like to send this out to my pastor and his wife and the congregation and Carl and Joyce Baker, Gail Hurt and her family. I'm trying not to forget names. Maybe I'll thank the other ones on the next slide. Give me your hand. Let's agree together.
Saving power, healing power, praise God. Amen. I'll tell you what, Sister Margaret, if we've ever been fought coming up here, we have been fought this time. Amen. Terry sprang her ankle, her foot. Praise the Lord. Cindy and them's a vehicle that devil tried to stop them with her vehicle. Several of us have gotten knee trouble, and
And Mama's not been well, praise the Lord. It's just been on and on. Brother Mike's having issues with his health. And I tell you what, the devil didn't want us to come, but I'll tell you what, he's not big enough to stop God's work. Amen. Praise God. If God wants something done, it'll be done. Amen. Praise God. There's not enough devils out there to stop you, friend, if you want to go for God. Amen. Praise the Lord. And I love him tonight. I love the Lord. Praise God. He's so good to me. Amen. He's just so good to me. Praise God. If I could take just a second and introduce a group, praise God. We want to send the songs out to Karen and Angie tonight. Maybe they're watching. Praise the Lord. But on the end here, we got Barbara and Mike Fritz. Praise God. They're husband and wife. Praise God. Sister Debbie's in the background. That's Mike's sister. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we got a new one with us tonight. Brother Jim Truitt, we call him Cowboy. Praise God. Amen. He's the cowboy of the group. Amen. And then over here, praise God, this is Brother Daryl Jones. Praise God. And this here is Sister Terry. That's Daryl's sister, Terry is. And that's her grandson, Dakota. And we thank their pastor for letting them come be with us tonight. Amen. This here's Sister Cindy King. Praise God. And up here on the end, we got Sister Connie. Praise God. And then we got Estelle on the piano and his wife, Molly, right here in the middle. And praise God, last but not least, of course, is my precious mama. Back here in the back, praise God. That's my mama. I love her, praise God. She's a jewel to me, praise God. I love my mama. She's been through some sickness and fought the devil a long, hard road. But I'll tell you what, Sister Shannon, she's still fighting the devil. Amen. Praise God. And the Lord's brought her a long way, and I love my mama, and I thank God for her tonight. Praise God. Huh?
Don't forget the piano player.
Yeah. And then we got some of the church with us tonight. Praise God. Husbands and wives and sisters. Praise God. Amen. All right. Who we got? Jim. Jim, you're singing, brother.
Oh, yeah. I'm in the light, huh?
Bless the Lord. If you don't know Jesus in the free pardon of sin, it could be your night. King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. Well, I'm down here in trouble. Please send an angel by my way. Well, if you're sick and afflicted and you don't know what to do, just call. Jesus, he will heal you, King Jesus.
Thank you, Brother Jim. Praise God. Amen. We call him Cowboy, but he rides a hog. That's what they call it, a motorcycle. Praise God. Amen. Amen. But hallelujah. We got some good talent here tonight. We want to work them. Praise the Lord. All right. Brother Darrell, he's going to sing his song tonight. Praise the Lord. I'm going to move over just a little bit. Praise God so you can kind of get him there. All right. G.
I'd like to dedicate this song to both of my brothers. Amen. They're both a bad sick. One of them bad sick. If I could go back when I was a lad, when I go to church with mother and dad, the preacher would preach straight from the book. He had no education, but he had what it took. The preacher would say, repent of your sins, give your heart to God and let the love light in. Jesus died on the cross of Calvary. He gave up his life for you and for me. If I could go back was a lad, when I go to church with my mother and dad, the preacher would preach straight from the book. He had no education, but he had what it took. Don't let education stand in your way. It won't take to heaven on that judgment day. Get on your knees and say all your prayers. Then you'll be ready for that meeting in the air. If I was a lad, when I go to church with mother and dad, the preacher would preach straight from the book. He had no education, but he had what it took. He had no education, but he had.
All right. Praise the Lord. Looks like we're going to do one more right now. Praise God. In this session, praise the Lord. Thank God. Sister Molly, you got your song ready, honey? All right. Praise God. Is that C?
I hear the roar. Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation to take me home. Oh, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my
thank you, New Vision Pentecostal Church from Richmond, Kentucky, and they are going to take a little break, and they'll be back with more songs. Vicki, I'll share this with you in case you. This request says Polly Carroll to sing a song. One to hear "Amazing Grace," and from another one from Madison County, Kathy's having problems with her knees, and she wants said the group is doing a good job. Thelma from Corbin enjoying the program and requests salvation for her family, and they need prayer. From Somerset, Mary wants to know where the where this church is located that we're talking about, so we can tell that after a while. Okay, well, y'all take a break and get you some water and come back refreshed, because we got Fred down here to see if we could wind him down or up or what. Let him tell us what he knows tonight, and then the group will be back to sing more for us. Well, you got something good there in your hands?
Well, had a lot of people being prayed for tonight. The phones is kind of pleasurable tonight. Oh. People calling and praying with people and yeah, believing and seeing responses.
Good.
And that's awesome tonight. A man needs the Lord's blessing on his life. Pray the Lord help him now that he's back in church, and the Lord mm-hmm. knows what his situation is. And if he'll stay with God, God will
yes,
bless him.
Absolutely.
And Perlin Jones has just prayed with his wife from Rockcastle County. She'd gotten a bad report, but he's a wonderful, wonderful mm-hmm. fellow. He's one of the guys really praying strong for me to have a kidney.
Oh,
and,
great.
Alvin Clevenger, their tree chilling in Morgan County, they're just looking at cataract surgery this week, so we pray for them, and mm-hmm. Prayer changes things.
It does.
Prayer changes things. I found out one thing about prayer. It's in trusting and believing. And when in trusting and believing, You just take God at His word. You know, in a relationship, like in a friendship, when you have a wonderful friendship or a good marriage or something like that, and if somebody says, I'm going to do this, what you do, you thank them, and you just go on expecting.
Let go.
There's not that worry.
No.
You don't hold on to it, and you don't get up every morning and think, you know, is He going to do this or not?
True.
And so trusting is the great key to what God does. I find that people who have, you know, we lay everything in the lap of faith, and sometimes we don't explain it, but trust is the key to God. And that is, if God knows you trust Him, well, anybody. If you know somebody trusts you, that means a lot to you.
Oh, yes. Sure does.
Know, that means everything. And so so it's wonderful. I'd like to give a shout out tonight to LaVon Carpenter. Her husband was a wonderful man of God. I read his name up here the other night, and I thought they was in Charlotte, North Carolina. I read his name, and it kind of startled me because I didn't think they was here. But this one, but he passed away.
Oh.
And they was faithful watchers of WLJC. Herb was a wonderful man. His name was Herb Carpenter. And he just wonderful. And so what he did as a minister, he left his clothes for me to distribute out among pastors and preachers.
Oh.
And so I did that. I think that's one of the most beautiful things. And so I told her tonight I would just let everybody know that he's passed away, and he is a great man, a wonderful man. One of those guys that didn't want attention all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Just worked and preached in the background. And so, to Vaughn, we love her. We appreciate her. I just want to send this program out to her tonight.
Yes.
And we got all kinds of them like that out there, Sister Mark. All kinds of them. And that's what makes it worthy to be here.
And you know, and you are spearheading through the Lord leading you to get more and more people to show love and appreciation for each other. I find this really, really a blessing.
Well, we, as a matter of fact, our next meeting is tomorrow night.
Oh, tomorrow night?
Yeah, because Memorial Weekend come up, the pastor decided that we'd have to move it back. So this is going to be the closest two we've had together because of Memorial. But tomorrow night, our second one. Tomorrow night, I'm just going to get out of the picture. Tomorrow night, I'm giving my church to another pastor, and he's going to be pastoring the church tomorrow night. And another pastor is going to be preaching, and he's going to be running the service, and I'm just going to be shaking hands and loving on people. And this has been a dream for many years. God set it up this year, and what we're doing is, every church that we can get involved with in our community, and so far all but two, to my knowledge, is involved in it. But this has been the most wonderful thing I've ever seen happen. And we're not promoting a revival. We're not promoting a healing service. Mm-hmm. We're not promoting anything but one thing, unity. And so that's what our key is. That's what we're working on, is unity and the love of God. And so it's worked great. I mean, it's you know, people talk about healing. I've seen more healing in these services that I've seen in all of the outspoken parts that we do. I've just seen great things doing and spectacular things. Pastors loving one another. Pastors
forgiving,
and I get a text I used to think I was alone.
Yep.
I get up on Sunday morning and fighting the devil, trying to get, now I get up on Sunday morning, my phone's, I'm getting one text after, I'm praying for you this morning, I'm praying for you this morning, I'm praying for you and your churches, and that's our neighbor churches. And so we're not trying to take one another's sheep. But this has been the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. And here's the thing about it, Sister Margaret. If we can be united, God can do anything.
Yes.
It's division that's destroying the church. And here's the way people deal with this. They don't believe like I do. So what? Everybody don't believe a life, but there's one thing about it. We have one common goal, mm-hmm. and that is Christ Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
That's Christ Jesus. And so I think it's the greatest thing's happened to me. I'm going to tell you this, and I don't mean this in a bad way, but this has been fought a lot from ministers, and it lets me know. I heard a guy tell me the other day, we need to break down these denominational walls. Baptist pastor sat beside of me, and he looked over at me, and he said, I thought that's what me and you was doing. And I said, yes, that's what we're doing. But I said, what he's saying is, he wants us to drop ours. He ain't going to drop his. Now, here's the thing about it is, unity says, I love you no matter what. Unity says, you belong to God, I belong to God, I'm going to love you. And unity says, here's my hand, if I can help you, I will. And the Bible says how great it is for His children to come together. Mm-hmm. It's like the oil that runs down off of Aaron's mm-hmm. beard, down through Horm and all of the places. And here's the thing about it. This is what blessed me. I don't feel alone anymore.
Hmm.
Because I've had friends in the gospel before, but they never come around. They never. But these guys is different. I mean, they concerned. I mean, they come sit down and they'll say, "Is something bothering you?" Mm-hmm. You know, and then you got somebody to pray with you. So
mm-hmm.
unity's everything to me.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe we got five more of these after this.
Hmm.
And then we'll close out in September, regroup and I think this television station, Sister Margaret, been pushing that for years.
Mm-hmm. Well, yes, well, we've tried. We've tried.
Yes. We've succeeded.
To a great extent.
You know, like Wayne and Cecil and you know, Wayne comes and hosts and
he'd
go upstairs and ask if I called in to get saved. You know. So,
that's that little mean street coming out in it.
That mean street, but you know the thing about it is, the love and the unity has been a big part of my life,
mm-hmm.
and I got a lot of that right here. I don't want to fight people. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to fight with people, but I sure do need them.
Because
man, I fought a battle over my years and biggest part mm-hmm. of time. If it hadn't been for my ministers here. Mm-hmm. I'd have been in trouble, mm-hmm. and this TV stay. And so we're taking that in our community, mm-hmm. and I'm proud of these pastors.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know, I'm proud of them, and we're going to take blows, but we're going to get a far better blessing.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah. And so you was there on the last one, and you know, it to me, it's just wonderful, you know.
It really was. It was... Now, you know, a lot of times people will say, oh, you felt the presence of the Lord. Well, I'm a little on the conservative side. You don't hear me mm-hmm. doing a lot of talking, but now I tell you, that night, the Lord even spoke to me. And you reckon I ought to tell this or not? Anyway, it looks bad on me, but somebody else might.
Not only that, I'll put it this way, and that is, I know of at least... 25 or 30 that God did the same thing to.
Hmm. Okay. I went to the church for the service that night, and I saw somebody, and I thought, well, what are they doing here? Because I know that in times past they had really not been the Fred and Brenda's friend, and had kind of backstabbed them, but. And you know, immediately I was resentful. And I thought, what are they doing here? They shouldn't even be here. And the Lord just spoke to me and let me know that I was carrying a grudge for Fred against that person when there was the reconciliation had already taken place between Fred and the man, But I didn't know it, and so the Lord was telling me it was not my concern, and that I should not be feeling that way toward Him. And you know, it takes something kind of strong to make me believe, but that was so plain that He told me it was not my concern that it was taken care of.
But and, that's real. Sister Murray, that's real. That's not fake. That's not... I mean, that's called healing.
Yes, that's healing.
That's called restoration. Yeah. That's what Jesus come to do. Jesus didn't come to heal one man and write 7 books over it.
No.
He didn't do that. No. Jesus come to heal every one of His children. And that's our bread. Mm-hmm. That's our bread. And when we quit trying to bolster ourselves in what God is doing, God's going to do more. Mm-hmm. And we have vowed a covenant between us men. No one will take any credit or any glory for anything.
Oh, wow.
And we won't.
That's great.
And
well, it surely brought the Holy Spirit there in a way that I had not experienced in a church service in a long time.
Yeah, that's right.
And so that it really works. And you know, well, that's having the unity, like you say, and being able to actually do what we're supposed to.
Yeah, and one time, when this September ends, people will head down Highway 52 coming towards Bethel, and they'll be able to pass every church. And as they pass that church, they'll be able to say, all of them people are working together.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
And that's everything to me.
Yes, it is. Yes.
You know, that's everything to me, you know.
Yes.
And so, what's going on in the body of Christ today is we're facing a real devil with superficial ideas. Mm-hmm. We got to get real. Mm-hmm. Now, here's the key to getting healed, Sister Margaret. Being real with God.
Yes.
You know, being real with God. And biggest part of the time, it's me.
Yeah.
You, it's me. Sunday morning, I told my church, I preached, and I went and got behind the baptistry and prayed. And I said, God, if I can move these people, I've got to be a repentative fellow myself. So I just repented, and somebody said, what did you repent over? Everything, you know?
Yeah.
Well. And I got my pulpit, and I said, I've been with God. And I asked God to forgive me this morning. And that's what I want Him to do in your life, you know? But we think we got God cornered and marketed in a human body? No. He's God and I need Him.
Yes. Oh, yes, yes. Well, I think it's a wonderful thing that is happening.
So sure tomorrow night at 6 o'clock at our church. Our church is the biggest, so they voted to use my building. Mm-hmm. And they said, well... I said, I'll step aside. And they said, that's what we want you to do. Mm-hmm. And you step aside, and that way it won't be your church, mm-hmm. and your building. And then all of the pastors is going to preach, and I started it, and mm-hmm. I'm going to close it out in mm-hmm. September. Mm-hmm. And I think that's going to be, and that's going to be awesome. And so words can't tell how I feel.
That's great. Okay. That's great. And all right, so the phone number to... If somebody wants to get in touch with you tonight, your phone number?
My phone number is 272.
Oh, I forgot last week I asked. Can you forget?
272-6712. So they can call that. Okay. And that's the church's number. Leave us a message and we'll get back to them.
Well, or just show up.
Just show up at church. My mind's about that long.
Well, okay, then. And they do have good padded seats, so you don't have to take your cushion. I like that. So, all right. Well, thanks, Brother Fred, for sharing that with us. And I'm expecting to hear some more good results and more good things happening because, you know, it's the way that the Lord wants us to move toward Him, but sometimes... it takes steps that we hadn't planned. We want to do it our way, how we've been taught. This is the way you get to God. Well, when we get down dealing with Him, we find out He wants us to just present ourselves.
Don't we circle the whole world, Sister Margaret, and eventually just come back and open the Bible and there's our answer?
Yeah, sure.
You know, because we want to speak for God instead of God speaking for us. Mm-hmm. And if we let God speak for us and that word speak loud, we'll be a flying.
Yes. All right. Now, that's tomorrow night. That will be May the 19th. Because mm-hmm. Shan's going to have her birthday the next day, and the 20th, and she's going to be 91. So, and she's already told me she did not want no old sticky ice cream cake.
No.
No, she said it's too messy.
No.
And so I said, well, okay, we'll get you soup, beans, and cornbread.
Just
she
to
said
make
she
a,
liked that
yeah,
better.
Just make a suggestion to her.
She's wanting the money, boy, dear.
Oh. Well, I'd take all the money and I'd get me a good moist cake and get me some soup, beans, and cornbread, and buddy, you can celebrate.
Yeah, that's...
That's two doors down from heaven, Sister Margaret.
Soup, beans, soup, cornbread.
Soup, beans, and cornbread is two doors down from heaven.
You got to have a little onions with that.
Oh, Lord, yeah. Yeah, well, now we're getting closer all the time.
All right. Well, we have our group back up refreshed, and we appreciate the spirit that this group has come in. They love the Lord. They're... And Vicki Young, the pastor of the church there. And
they got a whole choir over there.
She does. Brought them all tonight. And so New Vision Pentecostal Church from Richmond, Kentucky. So Vicki, tell them where you're located.
Praise the Lord. We're at 3313 Irvin Road, 6 miles out of Richmond. If you're coming from Richmond side, and if you're coming from Irvin, it'll be about 18 miles. And we'll be on your right side going toward Richmond. Praise God, 3313 Irvin Road, New Vision Pentecostal Church. We're right across the road from a Shell Mart, praise the Lord. Come and be with us. Our times of service is Sunday morning, 11 o'clock, regular worship, and we do have Sunday school at 10. Sunday evenings at 6 o'clock, and then we have a midweek service Wednesday at 7 o'clock. Praise the Lord. If I could right now, right quick, we're going to have a benefit singing this Friday night coming the 24th at 7 o'clock, and it'll be to benefit a family in our church. Praise the Lord. And we're going to have the praise singers from Irvin, and we'll have the Baker family, which is Molly and Estel, and her son is coming to sing that night. And we'll have the home church singers. Praise God. That'll be this coming Friday night, the 24th at 7 o'clock. Praise God. And all proceeds will go toward the family in the church that's in need. Praise God. You'll have come and check out our new sanctuary. We recently got new carpet. We got some new flooring in the fellowship hall and the kitchen area, so we're real proud of that. Praise the Lord. But come and be with us Friday night if you can, the 24th at 7 o'clock. Praise singers from Irvin to be there, and the Baker family, and then many local singers will have a lot of good singing that night. Praise God. So come be with us. Praise the Lord. Amen. All right. I think Sister Barbara's got a dedication here.
Yeah, I want to send the song out to my little granddaughter, Emily Carpenter, and my grandson, Kevin Bowen, and the Clay County Detention Center.
Amen.
This is for you, Kevin. Put your hand in his hand. Put your hand in his hand. Put your hand in his hand and don't let go. I've got my hand in his hand and I'm feeling mighty fine. I'm holding to his hand, he's holding mine. There is no other friend like the one that's holding my hand. He promised he'd go with me even until the end. When I'm
but the Lord is holding her hand. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Praise the Lord. Let's see what we got next. I believe that Sister Connie has a dedication there. Praise God. Amen.
Yeah, we want to send this out to Sister Susie. Mm-hmm. That's Wilma's
sister.
Sister. Mm-hmm. Okay, and I'm going to sing it out to the King family out there at Newby and everyone out in Newby and Waco and all the surrounding counties, Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
Let's just lift him up tonight in prayer.
Man.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
That they're watching in tonight, and I will send it out to them too.
I want to dedicate this broadcast out to my family, Lucille, Marthan, Luli, Judy, Rodney, and Kay, and Shirley, and all my nieces and nephews.
Amen.
I love each and every one of you all.
All right.
When I'm tossed on life's seas and the waves cover me and the dark clouds won't lift the sunshine through, may the voice seems to say, child, there'll be a brighter day.
Praise God. And friend, where are you going to call it home at? Amen. Praise God. Jesus loves you. Praise God. He died for you. Amen. That you might be saved. Praise the Lord. Amen. God loves you so much. He sent his only begotten son. Praise God that you could live and have life eternal. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We love Jesus tonight. We love God. We thank God for all things. He's healed my body so many times. I couldn't even stand here and tell it all night. Praise God what God's done for me. Praise the Lord. And I thank him and I praise him for that. Thank God. Amen. Sister Terry, praise the Lord. Amen.
Before I start, I'd like to dedicate this song to my daughter, my son-in-law, and his father. I know they're trying to watch it. If it come in, they was hoping it would come in. And I'd like to dedicate to my mother. And I'd like to send it out to Greg and Bonnie Mobley. She's over in the hospital. I'd like to send this all out to y'all.
Amen. Somewhere just across the Jordan River.
My friends and my
somehow I wish I'd done more. When I stand before the King in the judgment, in a gathering like never gathered before, and when they read from the book what I did for the Master, well, I'm sure I'll wish I'd done.
God. Amen. I wish I'd done more already. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All right, Brother Estel, burn that key up over there, buddy. They want to hear you sing something. Praise the Lord. All right.
Brother Estel. Oh, the river of death lies just before me. My Savior, for He's the one wanna walk with Christ my Savior, for He's the one that's got it all. Oh, He saved my soul and He made me happy. Now I'm out with God, I'm a traveling dog.
Praise God. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Glad I'm right with God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. All right. Sister Connie.
When I see the sunrise in the morning, when I feel the wind blowing cold, when I hear the sound
God, I believe in this place called heaven, amen. And I believe there's a Lord, thank God, that loves you tonight. And I believe, praise God, that he'll make a change in your life. Praise God, he'll heal your body. He's healed me many times, and I know that he's a healer, amen. Praise God. All right, praise the Lord. If we could, right now, I'm gonna ask my mama if she helped me out. I feel like singing that song we've been practicing, if it's all right with the church. Right now, praise the Lord, and then we'll get Mike to sing his little song. Praise the Lord. Praise God. I'm glad of my mama, and praise God. Thank God for touching the on her body and healing her many times. Praise God. Amen. All right, honey. She said with her breath, praise the Lord. Amen. Mama has been through a lot. Praise the Lord. But God's always blessed us. Amen. Praise God. First fret, guys. Praise the Lord. Amen. Either way, amen. Praise God. I'd like to dedicate that song to all of Uncle Mason Foster's family, amen. And I hope and pray some of them are watching, praise God, tonight. And if you are, God bless you. That was Uncle Mason's favorite song, praise the Lord. But we will dedicate to all of you tonight, praise God, amen. Kenneth, you're watching. God bless you, honey. We're praying for you. We love you, praise God. We love all of you, praise God. And one Uncle Mason's son's here with us tonight. We just thank God for him as well. Amen. Praise the Lord. Go ahead, Mike. Sing a song for your mama.
I'd like to send this song out to Homer. Brother might be there watching it with him. And I'd like to send it out to my mother if she's watching,
yes, yes.
Which I doubt if she is. But anyway, we'll send it out to them. There's a white oak on the hill at my old Kentucky home. Stand straight and true on the windy spur alone. But when the cold wind blows, its roots they bend and moan. And when
for my
Praise the Lord. Sister Cindy's going to sing us another one. Praise God. But like I said, we want to send the program out tonight to all of our church. Praise God. We had a few. Pat was coming tonight. Patty was coming, and things didn't work out for them. But we send it out to every one of you that's watching. Praise God tonight. Amen. We love you and appreciate you. All right, honey.
He's in the midst of our storm. He's in the valley we walk through. Where two or three are gathered in His name, He'll be there too. When you feel so all alone, He is standing next to you. He's with us now. Our Lord, He's in the midst. As you travel down life's way, He is with you every day. With every step you take, He walks ahead of you. Every night as you lay down, angels are camping all around. You'll never be alone, for He is in the midst.
God, I thought last week the Lord gave me a message about that. Praise God. He's in the midst, thank God. Praise the Lord. We're so glad of that tonight. Thank God, Sister Margaret, if you're going through a storm or if you're going whatever trial or anything you're going through, the Lord's hand is right in the midst of that, and He'll just reach down and bless. Amen. Praise God. All right, Brother Estelle, do the last song for us tonight for Brother Don. He likes to hear you play.
everything. So do us one there, brother. Praise God.
My heavenly home in my
Pentecostal Church from Richmond. Vicki, if you'd like to come up and pray with me over these requests, that'll be fine. We have a call from Greenville, Indiana, from Martha Hammonds, and that's says she's enjoying the program tonight on the internet. And that's Don's cousin, and he's a saying, tell her hi. So hi, Martha, from Don. I think that's this does it. A son from Wolf County and needs healing for his stomach problems. Irene from Jackson, this is a praise report. I'll let you read that one. It's not hard to cipher out. And here's Mabel from Oregon County, prayer for a 30-year-old man that needs the Lord's healing. He has a brain cancer. And wanted to hear the song just inside the gate for everyone alive and the ones that have gone on.
Amen. All right, praise God. Irene Steele, Jackson County, the Lord has healed her hip completely, and she knows she is really saved. She has no pain now. Praise God. Amen. Glory to God. We thank God for that. Amen. All right. Madison County, enjoying the singing tonight. Praise God. Amen. So was we. Amen. Praise God.
All right,
God.
We got...
enjoying being here.
We got one from Waco, from Norma, that said this is her church,
yes.
And she's... this is her...
Yes.
That is...
Yes, this is her church. She is proud of her church. God bless you, Sister Norma. We love you, honey. Praise the Lord. Norma Stone.
Okay, there's another one from...
All right. Praise God. Madison needs prayer. Amen. Praise God.
We will pray for you. Praise the Lord.
From
Amen.
Clay County, Josephine has been in the hospital twice in 1 month, colon tumor and so forth. Robin from Fayette County, a lady from Knox County, needs the Lord to take care of situations.
All right, Barbara Dennis, Madison County, tell Vicki and the Singers that they're doing a good job. We love you, Sister Barbara, Pam, Barb, all of you. We love all of you. Prayers for you. Praise God. Thanks for watching. We just love you. God bless.
Yeah, we was talking about you, Barbara, before service time. From Harlan, Ruby Banks family, Linda can't breathe tonight. Franklin County needs prayer to be delivered from an addiction. From Maria, Phyllis says she can't breathe tonight.
Yes.
Juanita from Indiana is septic and she has pneumonia and really needs help. Yes. Montgomery County, someone wants to be healed of mental illness.
Yes.
From Harlan, Evelyn is in the fourth stage of cancer. Here is someone pray for a son to be delivered from drugs. Kenneth from Whitley County pulled ligaments in both of their feet. Pliny from Breathitt County for a friend that has COPD. Kathy wants prayer to be delivered from smoking. From London, Veda needs prayer for Claudia, has pneumonia. Fern from Perry County for her family, praise the Lord for answering prayer. Willie from Harlan in a nursing home and his mom and dad. This is from Wolf County for Joe, had a heart attack and had stents put in. And let's see, we're Deborah from Madison County. You might know these people, Vicki, I'm not sure.
All right. Mother Pauline, Causey, Deborah, Sister Mary Blevins had a stroke today. Pray the Lord will bring her out of the stroke with no damage to her body. Amen. Pray for that. Praise God. Amen.
Okay, here's one from a mother for her daughter to get back to serving the Lord and to get off of alcohol and out of a bad home situation, and
Lord.
For the mother to give her strength in this situation and to handle the problems.
God.
That'd be very difficult. Whitley County, pray for a sister. A buddy from Breathitt County. Breathitt County, Jimmy and Denise both needs healing. Marlene from Knox County, someone has pulled muscles in her shoulder and for the Lord to touch her.
Bless
and
Lord.
Also a granddaughter that has cerebral palsy.
Bless God.
Beulah from and has cancer, and Pauline from the Corbin Nursing Home. Bless pray for these ladies to feel better.
Amen.
Here's from Breathitt County, pray for all the students that's going to the prom tonight. Pray for their safety.
Amen.
Breathitt County, Myrtle needs prayer for healing. Harlan County for grandkids and their situation. And we are out of time, Vicki, so would you lead us in prayer for these and all others that came in?
Amen. We'll do it. Father God, Lord, in the name of Jesus, God, we love you and praise you. God, we pray for these needs, God, Lord, those that have breathing issues, Lord, with strokes and heart attacks and, God, whatever in the hospitals and nursing homes. And, Father, we pray for all these tonight, God. And, Lord, we thank you for each and every one that's watched and ask your sweet blessings upon them, God, Lord. God, especially those that's lost and undone without you, Father. God, we just pray, Lord, send conviction to their hearts to be saved. And, Lord, we ask you, God, Lord, to bless each one and move, God, and answer every prayer. God, we lift them unto you tonight, Father, believing, God, that your prayer answering God, we've seen you move and answer prayers before, and we believe that you're able to do all things, God, that we ask. God, we praise you and love you and ask your blessings upon Sister Margaret, Brother Don, all the station, the staff here.
Jesus.
Father, we ask your good blessings, shield and keep us all safe and in your care. God, we pray people turn to you before it's too late.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name, we give you praise.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. All right.
Praise
Thank
the
you.
Lord.
All right. Once again, tell the folk where your church is located because they might want to come.
They might want to come, and we hope they do. Praise God, we want you to come.
Yes.
3313 Irvin Road, Praise God, about 6 miles out of Richmond. If you're coming from Richmond, we'll be on your left. And if you're coming from Irvin, it'll be about 18 miles from Irvin, and we'll be on your right. Praise the Lord. So 3313 Irvin Road. I hate to say that. I might give a plug.
Well, you, that would be giving them a plug, but you could remind them when you went and say they maybe give you 10 cents off a gallon or something.
Oh, okay. I could tell them that.
Just gently tell them, well, we
give
gave
a
you
a discount. We plugged you on TV.
Yeah. And all right, well, we're out of time completely, so thanks, Vicki, for bringing your church and for
being here
and the phone operators and the Lord's blessing. So from all of us here, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call us or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.